One of my favorite makeup products is blushes, and we're going to be talking all about drugstore blushes today. I'm going to be showing you my favorites, their texture, why I love them so well, and how they finish on the skin. So I hope that you're going to enjoy that. If you do enjoy these drugstore videos from me, please give this video a thumbs up. Don't forget to comment down below and tell me if you have a favorite drugstore blush and also the color of it, because I think that is really important too. Now, one thing that I do want to tell you is that most of my colors of my blushes are going to be on the cool toned side or neutral side because that is my coloring, but there are a lot of options out there. So I feel like even if this isn't right for your coloring, you could go into the actual formula and pick out one that was good for you. I'm not really going to be going into any order. I just want to show you the ones that I really love. So we're going to start out with the L'Oreal True Match formula. And this one is in color C5-6, and which means that it's a cool tone. And I think this blush is so lovely. Now, I first got into these blushes when I was watching my friend Kathy from Kathy Beauty Care Chats, and she was showing how pretty those blushes are. And you guys, the formula of them just goes on your cheeks so pretty. And they do have a ton of colors. This one is called Rosy Outlook. I love this blush because its tone is just the perfect mix between that cool and neutral for me. And even though it does say that it is a cool blush, and you can see that it is a cool blush, it does have a lot of peach in it, and I think that it's just so pretty for that, and it lasts a long time. That's about what all these blushes are for me. Is blush is the first thing that kind of fades on my face, and I know that a lot of you have this problem too. And so those are the qualities that I look for in the blush: what its tone is, what its formula is, and then also whether or not it's going to fade really quickly on my cheeks. And a little bit of a tip for you guys, if you do have a tendency to have your blush fade, make sure that you're not powdering before your blush. Make sure that the blush goes right on top of your foundation, you're powdering afterwards. It helps it to stick, and it's okay to put a little bit more blush on in the morning, because if it fades throughout the day, you're gonna have it still be there at the end of the day. So my next drugstore blush is from e.l.f., and these are their primer infused blushes that came out, I don't know, probably about 6 months ago or so. And this one is called Always Rosy. And the reason that I love these blushes is that they do have that primer in them, and they are going to stay all day. And especially the formula. The formula is so good on it. So you can see how that one is quite a bit more peach, or more along the lines of rose, than this one right here. A little bit more cool on that other one. This is a blush that can go with so many different looks. It doesn't matter really what you're wearing on your eyes. You could pick up this blush and it could go with all your looks. All right, my next one is from Flower Beauty. These are the Flower Pots, and this one is in Sweet Pea. And I think this one is so pretty. Now, the reason that I love these blushes is they're so soft, and you can get these in a matte. This formula is matte. And then there are other formulas in the Flower Beauty line that are more along the lines of a satin, almost a shimmer finish or a glowy finish, and that one is right there. Now, that one is one that is super, super along the cool side, but again, they have so many different colors to choose from. This blush right here is probably the softest formula, not really formula, the softest look of any of the blushes that I have, because it just washes out. So if you're just looking for just a slight flush of color on you, then this is really a good choice and one of my favorites for a very long time. The next one, I absolutely love this blush. I don't know how long they're gonna have it at ColourPop, but I absolutely love this blush for it being a nude blush. This is from Kathleen Lights and ColourPop, and this is called I Need Space. And you can see right there that already it's going to look a lot different than the blushes that I've already put on, but this is the most beautiful nude blush when you get it on your cheeks. It just shears out and makes your cheeks look like they've just got a very soft bronzy look to it, so you're not really looking at like pink cheeks or anything like that. This one right here is very, very peach. It's almost, like I said, it's almost along those lines of being like a bronzy color instead of any sort of a pink color, but it works so good on my skin tone, and I know that that would work on any skin tone because it's just a beautiful neutral blush. The other thing is the formula on this, you guys, wild. The formula is so soft and it's buttery. It's not like powdery when you have it in your hands. And then when it gets on your face, it's just gorgeous. And then, of course, you guys knew that I was going to have to put a Milani blush in here. These are the baked blushes. This one is Petal Primavera number 14. And again, the formula, even though this is a baked formula, sometimes when I use a baked formula, I find that I can have it be just a little bit too on the stiff side, but not this one. It's so pretty. And I'm going to run out of space here, so we're going to do our best. This one has that glow to it, that beautiful sheen to it, satin that goes across your cheeks, and it just brightens your cheeks. It's not too much, though, when you get it on. And I really like this one also for the factor of it being the neutral tone. So it can go either way. It doesn't really have to be a blush that just somebody that's cool toned or warm toned can use. And again, like I said, I love this formula in here. It's so soft and it's so pretty. So if you've been thinking about these blushes, a lot of people talk about Luminoso and a lot of people talk about Dolce Pink. I find that those are a little bit too harsh for me. They're just a little bit too bright for me, but this one in Petal Primavera is my very favorite, and I've been using it for a very long time, ever since it came out. Okay, the last single blush I have is from ColourPop. Now, if you have not tried the ColourPop Super Shock Blush formula, I highly recommend that you do. Out of all of them that I've shown you, this is the one that I feel like I can just put whatever amount I want on in the morning and it's going to be there at night. And that's because of its cream to powder formula. This is so creamy and so luxurious, and I can't begin to tell you how pretty this is on the skin, because it has that little property of this, the satin or the sheen, like the Milani one does, but it's in that cream formula. And so you're getting that little bit of sheen, and a lot of them will just be matte. I have a lot of their matte blushes and I love those too, but this one in particular in Prenup, it's just one of those ones that I already have a divot in, and it's one of those ones that I just use all the time. I'm reaching for it all the time. And the Super Shock formula, you guys, once you see it, you'll understand what I'm talking about. So if you have any problems with not being able to use powders, this cream to powder formula is so beautiful. I think that you will really love it. And then I have two palettes that I'm going to show you guys. The first one is from Juvia's Place. This is the Saharan Blush Volume 2. I think that if you get this one, you just about got everything you really need. I'm going to show it to you right here. I've already swatched it. And so there are all the colors. This color down here as a bronze color, or again, very sheared out as a nude blush, is absolutely beautiful. It is a matte one. And then this one up here, you can deepen up for my deeper skin gals. And it is absolutely gorgeous. It is the plummy color that I have right down here. And then that bronzer color is right there. And then the next one over here is a kind of a bright pink, and it's got that shimmery quality to it. And that one is right there, second from the top. And then right here is a shimmery highlighter color. This is a really beautiful highlighter color. And that one is right down here. Even though this does really well as a blush topper slash highlighter, it is a very, very beautiful, again, shimmery formula on that one. And then over here, you have your very, very corally orange color, and that one is right there. And then lastly up here, we have this pink coral color, and that one is right there. So this palette, I feel like it doesn't really matter whether you're cool or warm toned, whether, you know, whatever kind of blush you like, this palette is great for covering all the bases. I love all of Juvia's Place formulas as far as their pressed products go, and this is no different. It just blends out like a dream, and they're absolutely beautiful. And then lastly, I want to show you the Morphe. This is the 8C blush palette, and this has all cool tones in it. They do have an 8W, I think it's W. Anyway, that's all warm tones, but of course, we just talked about me being cool toned. So most of these blushes are definitely going to have a blue undertone to them. They're definitely going to be ones that would lean towards neutral and cool. I think that you could just pick any blush in here and be so happy with it. But if you really wanted to, you could mix two together, mix them all together, swirl your brush in all of them, whatever. You're going to get a gorgeous, gorgeous blush color. And I think that that's what I love about this. I love the formula that they have right here. These two right here are quite luminous. This one's luminous, and so is this one. But these two right here are more along the lines of satin, while those are have definitely got a glow to them. This one right here is a matte, and then all four of these over here are matte as well, and those are the colors right there. And I just absolutely love this palette. I've reached for it so many times. When in doubt, I go to this palette, I pull it out, and I can put anything on my cheeks. I can match any look I want to. So you have the lighter colors along here, you know, these are all lighter, but then you have the deeper tones and the mid-tones in there, and I think that this would match up with just about anybody's coloring. I think it's also fun to be able to branch out if you're somebody that has kind of been stuck in a blush rut and you wear the same blush every day. This is kind of fun to be able to explore your options and change up your blush just a little bit, maybe to go with your lip color that you're choosing that day or your eye color. And I really love it because the formula on it is so good too. The pigmentation is there, the blendability is there, and I feel like at the end of the day, I'm going to have the blush on my cheeks for sure. So one of the tips that I said just a second ago about not putting powder on and then putting your blush on, so make sure you do that. And then the other thing is use a good setting spray, and then you're going to have that set on there. And if you, unless you put too much blush on, don't use a powder over top of it, just the setting spray. And it really does help set it a lot. So those are a couple of tips that I thought that I would bring out. Hope that you did enjoy this video. If you're new to my channel, please consider subscribing. We would love to have you here as a part of our hashtag Mrs. M family. I hope everybody is doing really well. I think spring is just around the corner. I said that in my last video, but I'm excited for spring because I'm sick of winter. I hope everybody is staying warm today. Have an absolutely fantastic week or weekend wherever this video hits you. I will catch you guys all in my next video. Love you. Bye-bye.